So, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure to present our successful story and concrete offer of ICG before transferring know-how to the industry and plans for further development. I would like to start first from the end. So I think that really our value are the people who develop all this. And as you heard before, that really the question, you know, what we need to do and everything, everybody knows, but who will do that? So this is the answer. You need to have a very dedicated team of the persons. You have a team that they are, you know, developing this expertise, know-how during, the, you know, in many years. So we have 20 years experience in the production, purification, quality control of the biopharmaceuticals. So we have a Sotir, Corrado, Sulena, Venzi, Sia Jiva, and our ex-group leader, Sergio Tisminetsky, and our current leader, Marco Barale, and myself. So let me go to our mission, and you heard it before from General Director, from Marco Barale, that we are talking here about biologics, we are talking here about biosimilars, and just one sentence that over 80 biologics have been launched globally over the past decade. So we heard that there are many treatments to patients in different therapeutic area available now, and we heard that it's very high price, with a very high price, with a low accessibility in emerging markets. Our target are emerging markets, and we are really doing successfully with all our capabilities to access that market and to access this problem that are raw capacities and competence in the local manufacturing in emerging markets. So our solution, as you heard, patent expire, many leading biological products created this opportunity. We have started many years before the patent expires, so that is our key, started before the patent expire. So you can develop your own biosimilar that can improve access to these biopharmaceuticals, new treatments that can have a cost reduction, we heard, from 30 to 70%. So the question that we ask, all of us ask, is how similar biosimilars really need to be. ICGB solution is to develop this, and we actively developing sustainable technologies, this is really important, to produce biosimilars under your standards for emerging market. So we increase capabilities in the member states through the effective training. So this is really important thing. So you can see here in this slide that we developed technologies for 14 biosimilars over 20 years, and we scale it up. So as you heard, that labs scale, it's not it's not enough. So we realized that many years ago, and talking with our client, with our guests from member states, from pharmaceutical companies, and then we went through the scaling up, and we succeeded many of these technologies to scale it up to the pilot scale. And as you can see here, the batch size of the pure product in the gram, and we have calculated from this size, you can see how much of the doses we can produce for one single batch, and that can be like 200,000, almost 200,000 doses per interferon alpha, per GCSF 10,000 interferon, erythropoietin, insulin, long-lasting insulin, like few thousand doses. And what is most important, why I said the sustainable, because when we calculated the cost of goods here in Italy, paying on the small scale, you know, yeah, it's really low comparing to the price that we are paying here in Italy in the pharmacy. So we can go from 1,650 euros per dose of pegylated GCSF down to 7 euros that we need to produce it. So you can see that it's really sustainable technology, and we believe that we can reach every single patient in emerging market. So how? We have developed these technology transfer packages, and we call it technology in the briefcase, because it's really in the briefcase. You come here, your scientists, two or three scientists in our facility, we spend 4 weeks to train them. We are doing at least two batches, two to three batches, depending on the size of the batch, of the production, purification and quality control following European pharmacopoeia guidelines. So we have developed, and this is our advantage, that we have developed the technologies, all three platforms. As you heard, the World Health Organizations, they're trying to force this mammalian cell platform, and I agree there are many monoclonal antibodies now of interest, but we should not forget very important bacterial and yeast platform in biopharmaceutical companies, and I will tell you later on of the future of these platforms. So, bacterial platform, up to now we have developed in E. coli production of the granulocyte colony stimulating factor interferon alpha 2A, beta 1B. How it looks like. So these are all the pictures from our lab. We have scaled up the production in the bacteria up to 30 liters, and this is our fermenter, Sartorius of 30 liters that you can see here in our facility. We have a cell disruptor that is industrial scale cell disruptor that can be easily scaled up. We have protein refolding capacity up to 50 liters. We have industrial scale purification. You can see here our multigram scale. We have a 5-liter columns, and we can purify one single batch really of up to 5-7 grams of the protein. So we have all, of course, as you heard from before, that quality control is the most important thing. So we are following the quality of the product from the beginning until the end. We write the standard operation procedures, and at the end we have active pharmaceutical ingredient that is fulfill all the European pharmacopoeia monograph standards. So before, and usually what people have in their own lab is this flask scale, you know, small, high trap purification columns to purify a few micrograms of the protein. But then we really now reach this pilot scale, the very large fermenter, very large columns, and these columns are really today used in all the biopharmaceutical companies. So one of the products, how will the production and the process look like? For example, for GCSF, we have 10 or 30 liter scale. We can produce 6 grams of GCSF in 30 hours. We disrupt the cells. We have inclusion bodies. We refold it in 36 hours. We have diafiltration, cation exchange. At the end, we finish with the 3 grams of pure protein. This is the price. And we really transfer many times these technologies, and many countries are now producing GCSF on their own market with this technology. Yeast platform, we are using metallotrophic yeast Pichia pastoris. We have two products developed. This is human insulin and growth hormone. And again, we have a fermenter, this pilot scale. Insulin precursor is a beautiful molecule. It's produced, they've already folded and secreted from the yeast cell, and you have to do a few chemical modifications in order to finish with the human insulin. As you can see here, we are following every single day with the river phase the quality of production. At the end, we finish with the pure insulin for human use. Mammalian cell platform, up to now we developed the clone for the production of erythropoietin, and this was the most challenging, and I understand why a representative from Pakistan asked the question, why don't you start with E. coli, because this is our recommendation always, why don't you start with something smaller, simpler than the mammalian cell, because really during the development we faced different challenges. You know, we developed the perfusion of this production of erythropoietin is in perfusion mode. We have a bioreactor of 2 liter. Reactor volume is 1 liter. We are purifying with this, again, big scales, and we are finishing with active pharmaceutical gradient of the pharmacopoeia grade. So many, many different steps of purification to reach this quality. And we talked before, and you asked many questions about the quality and how to compare it. So I have to say that we are using European pharmacopoeia standards. There are standards that you can buy easily. You can buy even from Sigma that are European pharmacopoeia standards for erythropoietin. And the question from representative from Croatia before was, do they change these monographs quality control standards? Yes, they change because they put every the different batches, and they can put, for example, erythropoietin. They put a 50% of erythropoietin produced in the roller bottle with Anchorage dependent cells and 50% of produced in the bioreactor. So they're trying to put really these limits, your wider limits, but of course that it will not influence the efficacy of these products, because all of us in all World Health Organization, European Pharmacopeia, FDA, everybody agree, and all local authorities agree that the biosimilar product needs to be similar in quality and efficacy. So you can see here, it can be monographs are like the really detailed, you know, guidelines to related to quality. So physicochemical properties, immunochemical properties, biological activities, impurities. You have to do SDS page, eyes, electrofocus, in capillary. Do they change the test that they request? Yes, because some new techniques are more sensitive, so they are trying to change, like to exchange the isoelectrofocus for capillary zone electrophoresis, because it's much more sensitive, and we are always following the new monographs that are coming on the market. So a part of that, it's very important, lately, the last 10 years, all of these molecules, interferon, GCSF, can be chemically modified. So we have developed very good facility to chemically modify it and to obtain the pegylated, all of these pegylated molecules of GCSF interferons and erythropoietin, how it looks like and why people are doing, because the original molecules are what the mark, and then their patent will expire or already expired, because these polyethylene glycol modification, they influence, they have advantage in the increasing the protein stabilization, half-life in the circulation, they enhance solubility and so on. So we are really proud to say that all these years we developed the technology to pegylate the GCSF that you can see here, that is equally if not better than, but we don't, okay, it's not the bio-better, comparing to the commercially available original product. So we have developed like different five steps of chemical activation of PEG reagent and GCSF conjugation. Also, the erythropoietin has been pegylated here on the gels. You can see BDG molecule comparing to the standard, commercially available standard. There are six steps of the activation, purification, and epoconjugation. A part of pegylation, there are also very interesting story about the about chemical modification, fatty acid linker addition to the insulin to obtain these long-lasting histolins. So their patent will expire soon. So we phased also that new molecules. And the beauty of our platform is that once produced the insulin precursor in the, from the yeast, you can decide in the production, do you want to finish with insulin, like the rapid acting insulin, or you can chemically modify it in the lab to obtain the Detemir or Degludec. And we are really proud this technology. So transfer activities, as you already heard from Marco, we have many agreements, and maybe see, you can see now better in this picture, like all the countries where we transfer the technologies is, are in yellow, and the countries that are producing on their own market using our technologies. What does it mean? It means that our laboratory pilot training was efficient and enough to translate it to the industrial environment in the emerging markets. So what does it mean? That all these molecules already passed clinical trials, they pass preclinical. So what we are helping, we are really helping to face this most difficult part, and this is the first part, analytics, the quality. Let's compare it. Let's have a very good, let's have 99% purity. And then it's much easier and can reduce the cost of preclinical and clinical trials. So in green, these countries are producing using our technology. Okay, so then future. I like to use this sentence from the Nobel Prize winner board that said it's difficult to predict, especially about the future. But hopefully biosimilar opportunities worldwide are like put in these nice tables, and data monitor healthcare and different agency provide us these market opportunities. As you can see here, it's not just about mammalian cell, and it's not just about monoclonal antibodies, but in three different colors, I put the molecules produced in three different systems. So because we really think that this flexibility to have different systems, we can reach more market, we can reach different countries, different size of the countries, you know, countries with a different size, you know, and the different needs. So in blue, like Cimzia and Lucentis are Fabs. These are small antibodies produced in E. coli. Then in purple are the fusion antibodies produced in mammalian cell. And in green are Victoza and Levemir, are the small peptides and produced in yeast. So there is a huge opportunity also for these biosimilars. And of course, my monoclonal antibodies are welcomed, but they're very complex molecules produced in a mammalian cell. And we are looking to produce and develop the clones in the lab. But also fragment antigen binding the molecules are very interesting because they can easily penetrate tissues. They're relatively small. They can be produced in bacterial expression system that is easier and much cheaper. Okay, so, and maps of interest that we are looking to develop are the etanercept, that is a dimeric fusion protein anti-TNF antibody, and Fabs of interest are this cetrolizumab pegol, because we have also the good pegylation unit, so we can produce it in E. coli and pegylate it, and also ranibizumab is another Fab of interest. A part of it, there are different peptides as therapeutics, so more than 60 peptide drugs have reached the market, and several hundred of them are in the preclinical and clinical developments. They are easy to use to produce. They are very potent because they are specific, they are safe, they are more of action, that's safe mode of action of peptides. And one of them, a patent will expire soon, is like liraglutide, is a GLP-1 receptor agonist, and was approved for a treatment of diabetes too, treatment of the chronic weight management, and it can be produced in yeast and can be chemically modified by attaching the fatty acids. So this would be like further development in the ICGB, and we are looking forward. And just take home message, ICGB strategy that you heard before from General Director, from Marco Barale, that we really believe that biologics, and we are actively working, and we are demonstrating that biologics can be available, affordable to every patient in every country. We believe in sustainable technology. We can believe in a local production, and transfer of technology is our priority. So BDG advantages. Why BDG? Because we have more than 50 years experience in bioprocessing in emerging markets and training. We have three main expression systems, bacteria, yeast, and CHO. We have a pilot scale experience, very good synthetic organic chemistry protocols to modify, and we have established quality control analysis following European pharmacopeia guidelines. And these things really work. Thank you for your attention.